The Honorable Gorobi was granted a bail by court to do two things.
The Minister of State for Planning, Amos Logolobi, is among the three ministers who are battling cases of corruption before the Anti-Corruption Court, where they're accused of sharing iron sheets, which were meant to benefit the reformed cattle rustlers in Karamoja sub-region. Though he was granted bail pending trial, today he faced a trial in Parliament, as he was thwarted from speaking in Parliament by the outspoken Kira Municipality Legislator, Ibrahim Semuju Nganda, on grounds that he has no moral authority to speak to Parliament while he's still a suspect accused by the government he works for.
This process is a very serious process. We've been dealing with mainly the Honorable Musasi, and I speak as a member on the Budget Committee. The Honorable Gorobi was granted a bail by court to do two things. First, medical. Second, to defend himself.
There's an order here.
There's procedure, Madam Speaker.
No, even if it's procedure. Honorable members, let's have respect for each other. Yeah. Honorable Musasi is not here. There's a presumption of innocence.
Semuju went on to sting Lukolobi that he was granted bail to seek medical treatment, not to return to official duties to serve a government that arrested him and charged him corruption offenses.
All of us at one time, you will need bail. If court grants you temporary freedom, and then they see you very active representing the same government that has taken you to court and accused you, your colleagues are going to be denied bail on medical ground that immediately they grant you run into Parliament and begin transacting business.
Semuju was joined by Barnabas Tinkasimire, who challenged the speaker to make a pronouncement on the three embattled ministers who were charged in the iron sheet scandal.
This man holding the office of the minister, where the government that he serves charged him in court, what should we expect him to do? Should we expect him to continue working in the house, masquerading as a minister, when actually the government that he's serving told him no?
The Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, ruled that the accused ministers are still innocent until proven guilty by courts of law, and urged legislators to give them a break.
Honorable Lugolobi is still innocent until proved. That's one. And what we are discussing is a matter of sub judice. Can we look at matters of national importance? Chemonges.
However, members of parliament are divided on the matter, as some want the charged ministers to step aside until their cases are disposed of by courts, while others believe it's not necessary.
We came to the committee this time as a member. He actually sat there as a member, and I am satisfied he can sit there. But there is no way you're going to allow Lugolobi or any minister who has been charged to come and represent the government.
Why? Because they are innocent.
These are suspects taken to court by government.
This is the issue now between him as an individual and the appointing authority. If from his own perspective he feels he is not guilty until he has been proved by courts of law, and he feels he has not done anything wrong, and that's why he has not resigned.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.